गुड आफ्टरनून. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन. सो यू हैव टू नो व्हाट इज सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन. इट्स अ मेथड ऑफ डिटरमाइनिंग जेंडर बेस्ड ऑन द सेक्स क्रोमोसोम्स. ओके, आई विल टेल यू हाउ. वी हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन, प्राइमरी सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन एंड सेकेंडरी सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन. प्राइमरी सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन इज बाय सेक्स क्रोमोसोम. सेकेंडरी सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन इज बाय हार्मोन्स प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय डेवलपिंग गोनेट्स लाइक टेस्टोस्टेरोन इन मेल एंड ईस्ट्रोजन इन फीमेल. सो प्राइमरी सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, विच इज डन बाय सेक्स क्रोमोसोम. सो वी हैव सीन दैट प्राइमरी सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन इज बाय सेक्स क्रोमोसोम्स. देन वाट आर सेक्स क्रोमोसोम्स? एक्स एंड वाई आर कॉल्ड सेक्स क्रोमोसोम्स. Usually males are represented with XY and the symbol is this one. This is the symbol for male. Females have double X, XX and they are represented by this symbol. Okay. This is a normal human karyotype. As I said earlier, humans will have 23 pair of chromosomes, 22 pairs of autosomes and 23rd chromosome. This pair is called sex chromosomes. Okay, in males we have X and Y, in females we have XX. Okay, double X we represent for female, XY for males. Remaining 22 chromosomes are autosomes. Let us see what is the reason for a female child and male child. Usually, as we read, males will carry X and Y. Okay, females will carry both X chromosomes. So female will give ovum which carries X chromosome. We have multiple sperms. So some sperms may carry X chromosomes, some sperms may carry Y chromosome. Okay, so if the sperm containing X chromosome fuses with ovum which obviously contains X chromosome, then we get a female child because X and X. Okay, suppose if the sperm with Y chromosome fuses with ovum with X chromosome, then we get XY, that means male child. Okay, this is the concept behind a female child and male child. Okay, once again a schematic representation. Father carries X and Y, mother carries X and X. So we have four possibilities here. We may get a daughter if the X chromosome of father and X chromosome of mother fuses, then it results in the form of double X. So it is daughter. This is Y chromosome of father which fuses with X chromosome of mother, then we get X and Y. So it is male child again. Now we'll talk about this X chromosome. If this X chromosome is coming from mother and this X chromosome is coming from father, then we get a female child. If this X chromosome is coming from mother and this Y chromosome is coming from father, okay, then we get a male child. So every time we have 50% possibility of female child and 50% possibility of male child. It depends on the whether Y chromosome of father is fusing with the X chromosome or X chromosome of father is fusing with the X chromosome of mother, because mother is having both X chromosomes. Only father determines whether Y chromosome is coming or X chromosome is coming to fuse with the X chromosome of mother. So we should not blame a female because she is not having Y chromosome. Okay, father is having Y chromosome. Okay, he is solely responsible for male child. So what determines Y chromosome? So in testes we have SRY gene. This SRY gene is responsible for Y chromosome, which is responsible for male gender. Okay. So that's it about our topic, sex determination. You have to remember sex chromosome and how mother's X chromosome fuses with father's Y chromosome to give a male gender. Father's X chromosome fuses with mother's X chromosome to give a female gender. Okay. That you have to remember. Next, what is the what is lionization? Just read about lionization. This is the question of the day. This is homework for you. Thank you.